Sir, now tell us about, in brief, about the different varieties of cotton. What we are hearing, listening and studying in our textile industry or textile students, about Asian cotton, Egyptian cotton, Pima cotton, these are all things. Could you please brief about what are those varieties?
Actually, understand these type of cottons, we have to go for an individual species. It has been already told that we have growing four types of different species: Gossypium arboreum, Gossypium herbaceum, Gossypium barbadans, and Gossypium hirsutum. And only two species are growing more than 90% of the cotton, that is Gossypium herbaceum and arboreum. These two species are growing almost 90% of the overall cotton production in the world. In that India and China are the Asian countries are producing more of these type of species because these are climate suitable for this particular climate. Asian cotton, and the Asian cotton is not, when compared to quality, not as good as that Egyptian cotton or Pima cotton or Giza cotton.
Okay.
Not much the quality. In that we have three different types. So based on the length of the staple length. We have divided into three. A long staple that will range around 24 millimeter to 27 millimeter, and medium staple length, that is 20 to 24, and short staple length. This below less than 20. There are three different types of staple length in Indian production.
Yeah.
That is two different species. And come to the Egypt. Egypt has they produced Gossypium barbadans. This is a very, very good quality of the cotton. The staple length is excellent. The quality of the staple is very good. And the thickness and the shining, everything is very excellent. That is suitable to produce in that on the banks of the Nile River. In that, it is suitable for that particular area, and it is a well good cotton. That is called Egyptian cotton. Again, you go into the deep, that is Giza cotton. Giza cotton is also known as Egyptian cotton. Again, it is nearer to the some portion of the Nile Nadi. They will produce this type of cotton, and that is particular. This required humidity. A particular time they will produce, and particular time with proper maintenance they will harvest the cotton. Because of that, the cotton length and the thickness of the cotton is comparatively slightly higher than the Egyptian cotton. And among the all cotton, Giza cotton is one of the excellent cotton as of now. And when we come to the Pima cotton usually grow in the areas of USA. That is produced by Gossypium hirsutum. That is a different species.
Okay.
And that is also an excellent cotton. We can't able to differentiate the Egyptian cotton and the Pima cotton. Pima cotton is only used for production of subsidiaries. Okay, this is, when compared to Pima and Egyptian cotton is costlier than the Pima cotton. It is costlier than Pima cotton. Slightly, quality wise, the Egyptian cotton is slightly better.
Okay.
Only this difference is only because of the species and because of the adaptability of the species in particular area.
Yes.
That is the two. These four types of cotton.
Okay. Regarding for my audience, see, Egyptian cotton, Pima cotton, Giza cotton, or this Asian cotton. Asian cotton includes India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and Indonesia, and others, even China. These are things. The main, what I heard, the finest quality, the shirts what we wore, now in the markets are coming, there are high quality shirts are there, that's made of the Pima cotton. The quality, the comfortness, it gives comfortness, and the water moisture absorbability, comfortness, and also durability. These are the very compared to quality, these are very important. Cost wise. Okay. So short fibers are there, 1.5 centimeter, 2 centimeter. It's also good for blending with the other fibers. It's good too much of length. The what Egyptian fiber staple length is there, Pima staple length is there, this all is better. How much length is more is there, how much the fineness is there, that will help to give the good quality the clothing, that way shirt, that way whatever ladies wear, women's wear, kids wear, men's wear, we can do it. So just I'll come to the other point. Could you please let us know further tomorrow about the cottons nowadays? That is also important regarding the organic cotton and BT cotton. Nowadays globally organic cotton is more important. How the farmers are involved in producing the organic cotton and BT cotton?
Organic cotton and BT cotton is completely different. The organic cotton we will use the non-BT cotton for production of organic cotton. Here what we will do, we will use the organic method of cultivation. We will not use any fertilizers or any chemical to spray. We will use neem cake and green leaf manuring for cultivating this type of land, and green manuring, and we will use cow dung, FOM, formed manure, vermicompost, like that we will use in that. And to control the pest, we will use the plant extract chemicals. Like neem, neem extract we will use to control the pest. Like that, the crop is produced organically without spraying any chemicals or any using any fertilizers. That ultimately the organic cotton quality will be ultimately excellent, because we are supplying excellent quality nutrient and protein with organically produced. For example, if you have a kid, you are feeding your kid with junk foods or something, your kid will become fatty and no strength in that. So meanwhile you are feeding proteinaceous foods and fruits and vegetables, then your kid will become thin and very strengthen. Similarly in the plant also that will works with so strength of the cotton and the quality of the cotton, definitely organic cotton is good. Okay, and the yield wise 25% of the yield was less, that I agree, but the quality, when you go to the quality, then definitely the quality of the cotton is very excellent. When come to the BT cotton is actually a genetically modified crop, because the genetically modified organism has been introduced in a plant. That is, BT, Bacillus thuringiensis. It is a bacteria that has been introduced in a plant to control the bollworms. Because in a cotton, there were so many incidents of pest incidents is there. Because of the bollworm, we could not able to get the yield as we expect. So the BT cotton came into existence. There is biotechnologically the bacteria has been introduced in a plant. When the bollworm eats the leaves of the plant or eats the boll of the plant, then it will die because of that bacteria. Bacteria will kill that particular bollworm. So that because of that, the spraying and the investment is less. These things ultimately the yield wise more, but ultimately when you feeding more junk foods like without not much proteinaceous, and definitely the quality of the staple or quality of the cotton will definitely come down.
Yeah. Okay, for my audience, see organic cotton, what sir has told, organic cotton is grown in the farm. The product produced till the end, consumer end, that is the garmenting organic products. The products made by the organic cotton, the label, many global brands are producing many varieties of the cotton. Cottons used, labeled or tagged as organic cotton. This organic cotton itself is a more demand, and that is green oriented and environmental oriented compared to the what sir has told, the normal cotton. Just for your information.